हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर टू सी पायरोलिटिक एलिमिनेशंस। व्हाट इज मीन बाय पायरोलिटिक एलिमिनेशंस? दीज आर द एलिमिनेशन रिएक्शंस टेक्स प्लेस इन ऑर्गेनिक सबस्ट्रेट्स बाय द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ हीट और बाय द इफेक्ट ऑफ हीट। व्हेन वी सप्लाई हीट to the organic compounds, then these organic compounds undergoes intramolecular elimination reactions. So this pyro means, in Greek words, this is nothing but heat or fire. Heat or fire. So from this pyro word, Greek word, this is known as pyrolysis. So the pyrolytic eliminations are the eliminations in the organic compounds by the application or by supplying heat. These are the intramolecular elimination reaction are taking place by the supplement or by the application of heat. So in these reactions there is no requirement of any reagent or base. So no base or reagents required. So reagents or bases do not required in this reactions. Sometimes solvents are also even not required in the pyrolytic eliminations, but very high amount of energy, very huge amount of heat should be supplied to the compounds for the pyrolytic elimination reactions. So in these reactions, these are also having concerted mechanism. So concerted mechanism. What is concerted mechanism? We have seen in pericyclic reactions. So the concerted mechanism is, in this, the bond formations and bond breakings takes place simultaneously. Bond formations and breaking takes place simultaneously through the formation of cyclic transition state. So the cyclic transition state is generated. Sometimes 5-member cyclic transition state, sometimes 6-member cyclic transition state involved during the pyrolytic elimination reactions. So here we have to see 3 pyrolytic elimination reactions. 1, pyrolysis of acetate. Second, we have to see elimination or Cope reaction. And the third, we have to see elimination of xanthate compound. It is known as Chugiev reaction. So these are the 3 pyrolytic eliminations we have to see. One is pyrolysis of acetate, second is Cope elimination, and third is Chugiev reaction. Now first we have to see pyrolysis of acetate. Pyrolysis of acetate. Or this is the pyrolysis of esters. In this pyrolysis of acetate, so the acetate esters are undergoes heating at around 500 to 600 degree Celsius temperature and gives product alkene and carboxylic acid. So we have to see one example of this are CH2CH2OCOCH3. So this is one of the acetate. When it is heated at around 500 degree Celsius temperature, gives alkene and acetic acid. So we get here R CH double bond CH2. This is alkene plus CH3 COOH. So this is acetic acid, carboxylic acid we get. So in this, these are the reactions which are taking place in a gaseous phase. So all the pyrolytic elimination reactions are taking place in a gaseous phase by the application of huge amount of heat. So when this acetate undergoes pyrolytic elimination at high temperature, 500 degree Celsius temperature, gives alkene and carboxylic acid. Now we have to see its mechanism. In the mechanism, here this is the alpha carbon where the acetate group has attached. This is the beta carbon. So the beta hydrogen from this carbon, this is alpha carbon. Now this is beta carbon having R group. This is oxygen. दिस इज कार्बन हैविंग CO CH3 ग्रुप. सो आई टू राइट दिस इन दिस मैनर. सो हियर दिस इज द हाइड्रोजन वेरी क्लोजर टू दिस ऑक्सीजन ऑफ दिस एस्टर ग्रुप. सो व्हाट हैपन हियर, दिस ऑक्सीजन इंटरैक्ट्स थ्रू लोन पेयर विद दिस हाइड्रोजन. दिस बॉन्ड, दिस इज द बीटा कार्बन, दिस इज अल्फा कार्बन वेयर एसिटेट ग्रुप हैज अटैच. नाउ दिस बॉन्ड शिफ्टेड हियर एंड दिस बॉन्ड शिफ्टेड हियर एंड दिस टेक्स प्रोटॉन. सो थ्रू दिस सिक्स मेंबर साइक्लिक ट्रांजिशन स्टेट वी गेट हियर CH2. दिस बॉन्ड इज क्लीविंग ऑक्सीजन. दिस न्यू बॉन्ड विल गोइंग टू फॉर्म हियर. सो दिस इज कार्बन CH3. दिस इज हियर बॉन्ड ब्रेकिंग एंड हियर दिस इज न्यू बॉन्ड फॉर्मेशन CH. दिस इज द हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड इज ब्रेकिंग एंड दिस हाइड्रोजन मेक्स बॉन्ड विद दिस. सो दिस इज हियर R. सो दिस इज साइक्लिक ट्रांजिशन स्टेट, सिक्स मेंबर साइक्लिक ट्रांजिशन स्टेट ऑप्टेन एंड विच इमिजिएटली क्लीव टू प्रोडक्ट. सो इट गिवस R CH डबल बॉन्ड CH2 प्लस CH3 C डबल बॉन्ड OH. CH3 C डबल बॉन्ड OH. सो इन दिस पायरोलिसिस ऑफ एसिटेट्स, सो द एसिटिक एसिड इज लॉस्ट फ्रॉम दिस एंड गिव्स अल्किन एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. सो जनरली व्हेन अल्कोहल्स अंडरगोज डिहाइड्रेशन देन दिस मेथड इज यूज्ड. अल्कोहल्स फर्स्ट ट्रीटेड विद एसिटिक एनहाइड्राइड और एनी रिएजेंट फॉर द एसिटाइलेशन फॉलोड बाय पायरोलिटिक इलिमिनेशन गिव्स अल्किन. सो दिस इज द मेथड ऑफ इलिमिनेशन और द डिहाइड्रेशन ऑफ अल्कोहल्स थ्रू दिस पायरोलिटिक इलिमिनेशन. सो इन दिस वे हियर दिस सीन हाइड्रोजन, द हाइड्रोजन इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द सेम साइड. दिस इलिमिनेशन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज सीन और सीस इलिमिनेशन रिएक्शन. सीन और सीस इलिमिनेशन रिएक्शन. सो देर इज नो रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ बेस, देर इज नो रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ रिएजेंट. दिस इज व्हेन हीटेड एट 500 डिग्री सेल्सियस टेम्परेचर गिव्स डायरेक्टली अल्किन एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. सो हियर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड हियर पायरोलिसिस ऑफ एसिटेट. नाउ नेक्स्ट वी हैव टू सी कोप एलिमिनेशन रिएक्शन. इन द कोप एलिमिनेशन रिएक्शन टर्शियरी अमाइन ऑक्साइड undergoes pyrolytic elimination to give alkene and hydroxyl amine. So this is the reaction proposed by the scientist Cope. So it is named as Cope elimination reaction. So when tertiary amine oxide, so this is nitrogen having these two methyl groups attached to CH2 R. So this is tertiary amine. When this tertiary amine undergoes oxidation in presence of Fenton's reagent or in presence of per acid, metachloroperbenzoic acid, okay, so these are the different reagents for the oxidation of amines. So when this amine undergoes oxidation in presence of Fenton's reagent, that is Fe2+ and H2O2, or it can be treated with metachloroperbenzoic acid. So it undergoes oxidation at this position and it gives tertiary amine oxide. So here we get R CH2 N CH3 and here this is oxide. So nitrogen receives positive charge. So this is tertiary amine oxide. Now this tertiary amine oxide undergoes pyrolytic elimination in which this hydroxyl amine is lost. So this bond breaks here and on heating at around 150 degree Celsius to 200 degree Celsius, it gives alkene CH double bond CH2 plus N CH3 CH3 OH. So this is hydroxyl amine. So this alkene and hydroxyl amine is obtained from this pyrolytic elimination of tertiary amine oxide. Now how the mechanism is taking place? See the mechanism. So when this CH having this CH2, this EN, this is oxide, this is methyl, this is methyl, and this is here R group. When we represent this like in this form, so this is tertiary amine oxide, these are the two CH3. When this is alpha carbon, where this nitrogen is attached, which is leaving group, this is beta carbon. This oxide attacks on this proton, catches beta hydrogen, this bond shifted here and this bond get cleaved, electron density goes to electropositive nitrogen, and we get here, this is the cyclic transition state is obtained, where this CH2, this bond is breaking, this nitrogen is having two methyls, and here this new bond get formed, this is R, and here this hydrogen is, this hydrogen bond is breaking and it makes bond with this oxygen. This oxygen is having negative charge, so this is delta negative, nitrogen is having positive charge, delta positive. So here this is cyclic transition state is obtained during this pyrolytic elimination of tertiary amine oxide. Now here what happened? This alkene, so we get here this alkene and this hydroxyl amine. So RCH double bond CH2, N dimethyl, and this is hydroxyl amine, dimethyl hydroxyl amine. So we get here RCH double bond CH2 plus N dimethyl hydroxyl amine. So this is hydroxyl amine and this is alkene. So in this way, when we have to eliminate nitrogen from amines, so this Cope elimination reaction can be performed. This is the seen elimination, intramolecular elimination reaction, where this amino group we can eliminate from this through the formation of tertiary amine oxide and gives alkene as a product. This is here the Cope reaction we have seen. This reaction is invented by the scientist Cope, hence it is named as Cope elimination reaction. So all the pyrolytic elimination reactions are nothing but EI, intramolecular elimination reactions. These are called as EI reaction or internal elimination reactions or intramolecular elimination reaction. Intramolecular or internal elimination. So pyrolysis of acetate, this is the Cope reaction, these are the EI type of reaction where the elimination is internally takes place in the organic substrate. Just by heating they gives alkene along with the side product. Next we have to see Chugiev reaction. So in this Chugiev reaction, when xanthate ester undergoes intramolecular elimination in presence of heat, gives alkene and the carbonyl sulfide along with methyl mercaptan. So we have to see here first how the xanthate compound or xanthate ester is prepared from alcohol. So first we have to see the preparation of xanthate compound. See the example of xanthate compound, R O C double bond S S R. So this is called as xanthate ester. So this is xanthate ester. How the xanthate ester or xanthate compound is prepared from alcohol? When R OH alcohol reacts with carbon disulfide, that is CS2, then this oxygen attacks here and this electron density goes to sulfur and we get here R O C double bond S S. Now this S takes this proton S H. Now this is acidic proton. When it reacts with base such as sodium hydroxide, this OH minus ion takes proton, and when it reacts with electrophilic reagent such as methyl iodide, this attacks here and this iodide departed. So we get here R O C double bond S S C H 3 R O C double bond S S C H 3. So this is here xanthate compound. Now when such a xanthate compound undergoes pyrolysis gives alkene as a product. We have to see here one example of R CH2 O C double bond S S C H 3. So when this undergoes pyrolytic elimination at around 150 degree Celsius temperature gives R CH double bond CH2 alkene plus this C double bond S double bond O, so this is carbonyl sulfide, plus C double bond O double bond S and this CH3 S H plus CH3 S H, so this is methyl mercaptan or methane thiol, this is alkene. So alkene plus carbonyl sulfide and methane mercaptan or methane thiol. So in this way, when this undergoes pyrolytic elimination, we have to draw the structure like CH. So this is hydrogen CH2, this is oxygen, this is attached to carbon double bond sulfur S CH3. Here it is attached to R. Now this is alpha carbon from which this xanthate group has departed. This is beta carbon from which the beta hydrogen is lost. So here this sulfur takes proton. This electron density shifted here and this bond get cleaved and this electron density is goes here. So what we get? So we get here the cyclic transition state where this R CH, here this is hydrogen, here this is CH2, here this bond get cleaved, oxygen, here there is double bond formation, here there is bond breaking, here this is bond formation and this is SCH3. So this is 6 member cyclic transition state generated during the pyrolytic elimination and gives R CH double bond CH2 plus this R CH double bond CH2, this is alkene plus this we get here C double bond O, here this is S H and here this is S CH3. Now it cleaved to this sulfur attacks here and this electron pair takes proton and gives COS or OCS plus CH3SH CH3SH. So this is methane thiol plus this carbonyl sulfide double bond C double bond S. So in this way any xanthate compound can treated with any xanthate compound heated at around 150 to 200 degree Celsius temperature gives alkene and this byproduct such as carbonyl sulfide and methane thiol. So next example we have to see in this Chugach elimination reaction, when the alcohol such as CH3 CH OH C CH3 CH3 CH3, when it is treated with CH2 followed by methyl iodide, so when it reacts with CH2 followed by treatment with NaOH and CH3I, so what we get? We get here CH3COC double bond SSCH3, where this is HCCH3CH3CH3. So when this is the leaving group, this is xanthate group is leaving group, it is attached to this alpha carbon. Now this is the beta carbon, this is also beta carbon, but this beta has no hydrogen, so no beta hydrogen here, so beta hydrogen present here, so it is having beta hydrogen, and this beta hydrogen is interacts with this and we get the product. Now when this beta hydrogen, see this CH2, this H, so this is seen elimination, this sulfur takes this proton, this electron density goes to this, and here we get product. Finally this is CH2 double bond C H, this is CH3 CH3 CH3, so this is terminal alkene we get along with this carbonyl sulfide plus methane thiol. So in this way, but when this compound undergoes elimination, dehydration reaction in presence of sulfuric acid, undergoes rearrangement and gives internal alkene by the shifting of this methyl group. So when it undergoes pyrolysis in the xanthate compound, gives this terminal alkene as a product. So in case of Chugach elimination reaction, we have seen alcohols are converted to xanthate derivatives, and these xanthates are heated at high temperature around 150 to 200 degree Celsius temperature, gives alkenes as a product. So in all the pyrolytic elimination reactions, we have seen seen elimination reaction or cis elimination reactions, it is also called as elimination internal elimination reaction. There is no requirement of base, there is no requirement of any reagent, so these reactions are having first order reaction. So they are first order reaction because only substrate concentration determines the rate of reaction. So here we have seen pyrolytic eliminations in which elimination of acetate, that is pyrolysis of acetate. Second is COPE elimination, in which elimination in tertiary amine oxide we have seen. And the third, Chugach reaction, we have seen elimination in xanthate compound. Thank you.